All food comes from plants, but how do plants make their food?
This process is called photosynthesis. However, before telling you how plants make their food, you must know that there are different adaptations and parts in the leaves that do different things. Leaves have adapted in many ways, like having a bigger surface area to absorb more sunlight, many veins that carry the elements around and support the leaf, and leaves are thin so the elements do not have to travel far.
Internal system of a leaf where photosynthesis occurs is made up of the cuticle,
the epidermis, palisade, the spongy mesophyll layer, the main vein, and the stomata. The cuticle is the waxy and waterproof surface of the leaf that we see. There are two epidermises in a leaf, the upper epidermis and the lower epidermis. The lower epidermis has many microscopic holes called stomata. The stomata are where the leaf takes in carbon dioxide and emits the oxygen. The upper epidermis is transparent to allow sunlight to get through and reach the palisade. The palisade contains chloroplasts, where most of the photosynthesis takes place. The spongy layer contains irregular cells with large spaces for exchange of gases, which are carbon dioxide and oxygen. The main vein of the leaf consists of the xylem and the phloem. The xylem transports the water to the entire leaf, and the phloem transports the plant's food back out.
All of the parts of the leaf contribute to the process of photosynthesis, and the plant uses them to make food. To make their food, plants need a green pigment called chlorophyll, water, sunlight, and carbon dioxide.
The plant uses its roots to gather water and nutrients from the ground. The plant then takes in sunlight and carbon dioxide from the surrounding air through the stomata. The chlorophyll then combines these three elements to make the food that the plants eat. This food is called glucose.
There are two more factors that are a part of photosynthesis: transpiration and respiration. Transpiration is the process where water is emitted from the leaf through the stomata. This is done to regulate the temperature of the plants so they do not overheat. Transpiration also allows carbon dioxide to enter the plant because the stomata are wide open when the plants transpire. If the stomata was closed, photosynthesis would not be able to occur.
Respiration, unlike photosynthesis, occurs in the day and at night as it does not require sunlight. Respiration is the process where the sugars made during photosynthesis are burnt to make energy. Also, respiration uses oxygen and produces small amounts of carbon dioxide.
And there you go, photosynthesis.